Hello and welcome to another edition of Cinema Club. I'm on my own this week. Everyone else was quite busy this weekend, so I've had to do this one alone. So without any further ado, let's get into this week's film, which is Florence Foster Jenkins.
Music is my life.
Can you imagine what that must feel like? To hold 3,000 people in the cup of your hand. Mm.
Florence Foster Jenkins is a British biographical comedy drama film directed by Stephen Frears. The film stars Meryl Streep as Florence Foster Jenkins, a New York heiress who became an opera singer notorious for her lack of singing skills. Other cast members include Hugh Grant and Simon Helberg. So there you go, that's a rundown of Florence Foster Jenkins, and surprisingly, I quite enjoyed the movie. It's not one of those I'll run out and buy on DVD or anything, and it won't be one that I'll watch again and again and again, but I would recommend at least one viewing of this film. The cast are all really good in the film. We have obviously Meryl Streep playing the lead character. Hugh Grant plays her husband, and I usually don't like Hugh Grant, but I didn't mind him in this. He's not the charming British pompous person he usually plays. He's just playing his role, and I thought that was great. For you Big Bang Theory fans out there, we also have a role for one of the guys from Big Bang Theory. I do apologize, I'm not into Big Bang Theory, so I don't know the characters' names, but I'm sure he's on screen now, so you'll all know exactly who he is. And again, he plays his role fine. It's quite an inspirational story. I know they put these kind of films out there, the inspirational story about this kind of person and this kind of person, but it really was. I took a lot of away from this personally because, well, not to say things about myself or anything, but I'm sure a lot of you get this as well, that when you want to do things in your life, you're always told, oh, you shouldn't be doing that, you're not very good at it and everything like that. Whereas this film shows that if you have a passion for something, then just do it. And if it makes you happy, do it. I mean, I do videos and things like that, and probably a lot of people out there who would watch my stuff would probably say, God, that's crap, that's this, that's that. But I enjoy it. I enjoy what I do. And this film really spoke to me because she just loves music in every way imaginable. And you really see that. And that's a credit to Meryl Streep in this role, because she really makes you believe in the character that she's playing. One criticism I will have about this is towards the end, there was a couple of times I thought, right, this is where it's going to cut and everything like that. And it didn't, and it kept going. And I thought maybe they should have stopped here, because it does kind of follow the similar sort of tropes of this kind of movie. It has to end on a certain thing. And if you've watched quite a few films of this kind of tale, then you can probably guess where the ending is going to go. I love sort of old 1940s, 1950s, that kind of period of like America and Hollywood and New York. And this really emphasized that for me, because it looks glorious on screen. It always looks good on screen. The colours really pop in this as well, because there was a scene where she's in a yellow taxi and it's going into an alleyway, and the taxi cab just popped out of the screen because of the bright yellowness of it. And there was a couple of British people in this as well, I did notice. They're not really sort of names, but they're people who you'll recognise from sort of like British television and things like that, and British films. So keep your eye out for them, because this film was put out by the BBC, so I can understand why they've cast those people. But all in all, I really did enjoy it. Like I said, it's not one I'm going to go back to time and time again, but I probably will recommend people to see it. If you're going to pay for it, maybe wait for the DVD or wait for like a rental or something like that, but you won't be disappointed with it. It's not something that's, like I thought, was going to be geared solely at an older audience. It's something that everyone can enjoy. It has a lot of comedic moments, as by the subject matter it deals with, because the moment she opened her mouth for the first time and started to sing, the screen I was in just started giggling and laughing, so obviously people were enjoying that aspect of it. And there's some great moments, as I said, with the guy from the Big Bang Theory. I really enjoyed his portrayal of his character on screen, especially when you hear her sing for the first time, because The facial expressions he was pulling were perfect. Couldn't have done it any better myself. So, final thoughts on this. Go see it. Maybe not in the cinema, but wait for a rental or something like that, and you'll really enjoy it. I guarantee it, because it's a charming film, shall we say.
Expand your diaphragm, Florence.
Do I try another take?
Well, I don't see why. That seemed perfect to me.
Well, that's it for this week's episode of Cinema Club. Thank you very much for watching. Take care, and I'll see you next week.